and recap real quick because we only have 10 minutes. What is, what are the big two kinds of sequences? You could all make up whatever sequence you wanted, but there are two very big, broad, special kinds. What are they? Geometric and arithmetic. Now, what's the difference?
Geometric is multiplying.
The different term to term by multiplying, right? And our formulas for geometric, I'm not gonna ever write these down again like this, so if you don't have these in your notes, you need to get them there. A refers to a term, S refers to a sum, because sometimes we don't want to know just what the number is, we want to know what all of them added up on. And here are the arithmetic. So what I want you to do is in that packet that I was giving you out, the one we were working in yesterday, would you turn to page 2? We're just going to run through a couple of problems I did yesterday, and then a new one, and then we'll be out of time probably. So here we go, number 1. We're on page 2, Frances went bowling every single day for exactly 3 weeks. The first day she got 3 strikes, the second day she got 5, she got 7, and then yeah. If Fran can keep her streak alive, how many strikes will she get on the last day? Okay, so who remembers, what are the two kind of big questions that come through our mind? Oh, if we're still working on our test, we need to turn it in. Time is up. We need to turn it in. Make sure your names are in, turn it in. Brenton? If it's geometric or arithmetic. So Brenton, which is it?
Arithmetic.
Yep, it's arithmetic, which means we're getting from term to term by adding. And what are we adding?
Two.
Okay, now remember, you got to be adding the same thing. If you're going to use these formulas, you have to be getting from term to term by adding the very same thing or multiplying by the very same thing. Okay, then what's the second question? We've determined it's arithmetic, which puts us down here. Do I want a number or a sum? So I read the question very carefully. How many strikes will she get on the last day?
I want
a number, right? I want the number, I want one of these. This is how many strikes she got on the first day. This is on the second day. Well, I want to know which term.
21st.
So the 21st term, according to my formula, is the first term plus the difference times 20. So I think she got 43 strikes, if I did my arithmetic right. She got 43 strikes on the last day. That's a lot. All right, now number 3. Nate is going to start a savings plan for college. He's going to save for exactly 12 days. He saves 6 cents on the first day, 18 on the second day, 54 on the third day, and so on. If he continues this pattern, how much will he save on the 12th day?
Well, this is multiplication.
We're multiplying by 3. So it's geometric. How much will he save on the 12th day?
So this is term.
Well, I heard someone say sum, someone say term. Which is it? It's term. If we wanted the sum, how could the problem be worded?
How much will he have by?
How much will he have saved? Right? Add that one little word in there. How much will he have saved? That means sum, right? That means add it all up. So we want the 12th term. That's going to be a big number. Remember that the unit was cents, so we'll want to change that into dollars because nobody talks about that many cents. What'd you get? 10,628.82. Geometric sequences grow very, very, very fast. They grow exponentially. Look at the at an exponential, and we know that exponentials, when we graph them, look like this. This is where you are, growing, growing, growing really fast. Okay? Now, let's do something a little bit different. We did ones like this yesterday. Let's look at number two. The sixth term of a geometric sequence, right here, term geometric, is 160. If the first term is 5, find the ratio. Any thoughts on how we might do that? Now, everybody needs to be clued in. You're using this formula. It's a geometric term. So we're looking at this formula. Mallory, what's your thought? Whoa! What do you think about that, people? She is right on target. She says the last term I'm concerned about, the ending term, is the first term times the ratio to the n minus first. That exponent's 5 because this is the sixth term, so n is 6, so the exponent's 5. How do you want to solve that? Divide by 5. And then luckily it all works out marvelously. What to the fifth power is 32?
2.
So the common ratio is 2. Nicely done, Mallory. All right, number 4. Probably our last one. Here we go. Is 2009 a term of this sequence or not? And you can't just say yes or no, you have to explain yourself. So if we kept going with this sequence, negative 3, 1, 5, 9, would eventually we get to the number 2009? Anybody have a thought on that? This one.
Is it geometric?
Is it geometric? I think it's arithmetic. How are we getting from term to term? Looks like we're adding 4. So now we're going to be using this formula, right? So what is your thought? Think like Mallory thought. She's right on, or she's in a different formula. So 2009 equals negative 3 plus 4 times n minus 1. Now what does n stand for in this formula? The number of terms. So I want to know, is this the 100th term? What is the n value? All right, so let's solve that. I'll add 3. And I'll divide by 4. So n is 504. I think if my arithmetic is accurate. So what's the, is it wrong?
Oh no, I just had a question, like, how would you know?
Well, let's talk about that. Which term is this? It's the 504th term. All right, so I want you to pretend something. Let's pretend for a minute that this had been 2008. Okay, then this would be 11. And then when I divided here, I would get like 2.75 or something. I'm kind of making this up. I think I'm right, but I'm not positive. But the point I'm trying to make is, what did you say N stood for? The number of the term. So it's got to be the 8th term, the 9th term, or 10th term. It can't be the 7.5 term. So if you solve, does that make sense to you?
Yeah.
So if you solve for N and you do not get a whole number,
then it isn't
a term.
So do we say yes to the whole number?
Yes, it's the 504th term. It worked out. It came out perfectly. Okay, you're going to get a chance to get back. This is on Friday, so I need to.